everyone. This is an eye-opener I want to give to you. In the world, because we all came out of the world as believers, you're being taught that strength makes right, that might makes right. You see, and in the world, if you cannot use violence to defend yourself, you're seen as weak, you're seen as non-worthy. In the world, the violence of the masses are always justified. That's why we have mythology. That's why we have religion, to justify the anger and dissatisfaction of the masses. Because that's how every nation keeps themselves intact, is by pouring out their frustrations. A weak member. A weak member can be someone that's not capable of defending themselves, or can be just a random individual, a man or woman they should select and they victimize. Now listen, victimization happens to everyone from time during his lifetime. There are people who are marked as collective victims. It can be in high school, it can be in families, or it can be through the media. The magic of victimizing, of collective victimizing, works. It gives the collective, it means either the family or the students at the high school or the community, gives them relief, and this relief will cause. It's the direct effect of that magic, is that people that are similar will group together. So you will get order in a society, you will get order in a community. And then you have reenactments of the official trauma that was inflicted upon the victim. But there's one thing. There's one thing that the world will never tell you. Anytime you decide to agree with victimization, anytime you agree with negativity, else, what I mean with negativity, I'm not talking about when you have evildoers receiving back their evil that they wanted to put out on the community. I'm not talking about that. I'm not talking about justice. Anytime you agree with evil upon someone else, you are deforming on the inside. Because that's what it's all about. We want to have power to make things conform to our being stuck. Because in the world, people are stuck. And they want the environment to reflect how stuck they are on the inside. Once that's not the case, they become frustrated and they want to pour out their frustration on someone else. You have parents doing that with their children, some children with their parents. It happens all the time. Here's the thing. When you get away with doing that because you're a part of a crowd and it's hard to deal with a crowd, listen, you're not free. Because weakness will never depart from you when you are in agreement with it. That implies, because listen, this is how it works. Anytime you agree with a curse or some harm upon someone else, what's happening is demons become attached to you. They get a hold of your emotions and of your mind. So without you being aware of it, you have now become a captive of evil spirits. And while you're the one who won, you didn't win. Not win at all. It doesn't matter whether you just lash out at someone, or you beat someone up, or that you literally physically murdered someone. You never get away of the curse you've agreed with. Okay? And listen, I want you to use discernment with what I'm saying here. If you have evildoers who are purely evil in a community, and people are praying, and they perish, now, we don't agree. And we're not glad with human beings perishing, we are glad with the wicked being removed. Okay? So being glad that the wicked are removed, that's not evil. Even the Bible encourages that. I'm talking about the other thing. About you being dissatisfied and you want to lash out and victimize someone else. Or you just have a will, you want something, somewhere else is an actor hindering it and you act out against the actor. Such things. May you agree with anything like that, you become deformed. So, a lot of people, for example, are going against Donald Trump right now. people wishing him death. They even open about it. They release psychic attacks upon him. There are even people going to his rallies to disturb what he's doing. Or in Europe, you have people going against Angela Merkel at the moment. So it's happening towards potential or real political leaders. It also happens on the lower scale. For example, you can have a boy at a playground that's shunned by the other children, and both the children and their parents are lashing out against the kid behind the kid's back. So even they treat the child in his face because they know nobody will. The child has no parents. Either he's an orphan or his parents are not capable of vindicating him. Listen, those people have success because they act out, right? But nobody tells them about the lifetime curses and destructions they are bringing upon themselves. And especially, nobody is warning them of the horrors and the terrors they will endure forever for eternity in the lake of fire. Because, listen, they don't see the full picture. They don't want to see the full picture. Because if they would see the full picture, they would have repented. And here's the thing. Anytime the Most High sends them evangelists and preachers and whatever, whenever the Lord sends His anointed people into their midst, is to give them the full picture of what reality is, of what the truth is. They reject it. Now listen. There are a lot of people who are involved with mob violence and with negativity without being aware of it. So the Lord will send out His people to warn them, to give them the full picture. Okay, now listen. Once an individual hardens themselves, when he or she hardens himself or herself against the truth, and they persist, while knowing the full picture, they persist into their fantasy, what else the Lord will do? The Holy Spirit will depart from striving that individual, and when once that happens, evil spirits will take full control of that individual. Okay, this happens to Saul in the Old Testament. Saul was not a believer. He wasn't. And time and time again, Saul resisted to surrender unto the Most High. So what happened? The Holy Spirit departed from him. The Holy Spirit was not in him because he was not born again. The Holy Spirit was striving with him. After a while, when Saul remained, kept hardening himself and kept making excuses, holding on to his negativity, the Holy Spirit left and an evil spirit went into Saul and onto Saul. And David was chosen by the Lord. David surrendered himself to the Holy Spirit, and he remained repentful throughout his life. And after, just look at this. In his teenage years, when David was anointed, you see, what happened? David did not harm Saul, nor did he intend to harm Saul, but Saul wanted to harm David. Saul was afraid of the Holy Spirit that was living inside of David. Why? Because he had a demon spirit. He had an evil spirit. Of course, Saul is going to act out against David. Now, Saul did wound David by persecuting him for 13 years long. But what happened? The longer Saul persecuted, the more deformed Saul became. The more inhuman Saul became. Not only that. Remember, Saul was elected king because the Israelites rejected the rulership of the Most High because of the nations. So Saul was a reflection of the people's cruelty. What happened now? Saul was persecuting David, right? Now, Saul's anger and wrath, because he couldn't do anything to David because David was protected, Saul's anger was released upon the same as king. Saul committed genocide, he defrauded people, man, Saul went out of control. And those people among the population that were against the Lord, they now had to deal with their own wickedness through Saul. You see? So, it wasn't just about David, okay? It was the wicked Israelites receiving back what they saw. Right? They should have just received the grace of God, but no. They want to do things their way by sowing and reaping, so now they have to reap what they sow. Okay? Now look, I'm going to say it once more. Nobody that agrees with wickedness goes free. Nobody. Satan isn't going free. Those demons aren't going free. And neither are those people who are in agreement with wickedness, are they going free. They are stuck to the negativity they've agreed with. So listen to this. I don't know how your boss was. I don't know who did you wrong. I don't know how often they did you wrong. I don't know how often they've talked behind your back about you. They dehumanized you. Listen, those people, they've agreed with darkness. So now darkness has taken hold of them. And they're not even aware of it. Some do, but they want to blame you. Because, of course, according to them, it's never them. It's always someone else attacking them. They never want to take responsibility. They are in denial. But look at this. It doesn't matter if they keep on victimizing you. It doesn't matter if they keep on blaming you. If they keep on wanting to make things harder on you. They are in denial that they are agreeing with darkness. And that denial is going to finish them. That denial is going to be their ruin. So listen. Often the Lord will not deal directly with the wicked. You see, there are times, of course, that the Lord will send out these angels. Those angels will either remove the wicked through circumstances by chasing them away, or the Lord will take out the wicked, really killing them. The Lord does that. And of course, you know, demons themselves will deal with wicked people when those wicked people are hindering the agenda of the demons. But listen, most of the time, you see, the Lord will not, of course the Lord is active, don't get me wrong. The Lord will permit the wicked to rage. The Lord will give space that the wicked can do their thing. Why? Because the Lord is giving them enough rope to hang themselves. That's what the Lord is doing. The Lord knows very well they don't want to repent. The Lord knows very well that they will always come up with excuses and with all kinds of stupidity to try to justify their willful insanity. So what else the Lord do? The Lord rage and rage. And the more they rage, the more the hardness of their heart is killing them. And at Judgment Day, the Lord will simply reveal all the evidence at the last judgment, and they'll be deported to the lake of fire. That's it. Look, just because you don't see any direct consequence on people that persist in wickedness does not mean that the Lord is in agreement with it, nor that what they are doing is right. As I mentioned before, there are times that the Lord will act out directly. And as you can read in the Old Testament, also in the New Testament, there are instances where he acted directly. And there are times where the Lord will let their own negativity work itself out. And this is not only for people that are wicked, also for evil spirits. You see, when the Apostle Paul was haunted by an evil spirit, remember, the Apostle Paul had authority. You know, he talked about spiritual warfare and all of that. Yet, there was this demon that was harassing him and following everywhere and causing trouble through other people. The Lord said to Paul, "My grace is sufficient for you. This weakness you're in that you cannot deal with this, I'm going to use it to reveal my strength." And look, this is what I've said about those wicked people. It comes for evil, for wicked spirits also. The Lord will often let their negativity work itself out. When you go through history and you evaluate human history, you can see many religions that collapsed. Many, because those religions were demonic. Being said to you all, I hope this video has inspired you, and may the grace of God be with you. Shalom.